Let's go on an adventure into music history. It's the Composer Chronicles from Dynamic Doodle.
Hello there. Nice to see you, darling. My name is Florence Price. I'd love to share a little about myself if you want to cozy up and have a listen. I was born on April 9, 1887 in Little Rock, Arkansas, and I was one of three children in my family. My family was well respected in our community, and my daddy was the only black dentist in our city. My mama was a music teacher, and she started teaching me at a very young age. In fact, I had my first piano recital at age 4, and even wrote my first piece of music at age 11. Now, after high school, I moved to Boston, Massachusetts, and enrolled in the New England Conservatory of Music to study organ and piano teaching. Do you want to know a little secret? I was so nervous about how people might treat me as a black woman, so I convinced my peers and professors I was Mexican instead, and that I moved here from a town called Pueblo, Mexico. Well, in 1912, I met and married my husband, Thomas J. Price. He was a well-respected lawyer. Thomas and I moved back to Arkansas together, but the racial tension continued to grow. So we decided to leave and settle up north in Chicago. It was here that I began taking my music writing more seriously. Look, honey, I started writing lots of music and loved it, but my relationship with my husband was struggling. We got a divorce when I was just 44 years old, and I was left to care for my daughters alone. I ended up moving in with my dear friend and fellow composer, Margaret Bonds. Margaret and I continued to write music and people started loving it. We were finally getting national attention for our music that we deserved. By 1940, ooh, honey, I was inducted into the American Society of Composers, Authors, and Publishers. I had won many awards and was even recognized as the first black woman to have music performed by a major U.S. orchestra. Mama would have been so proud. My career had really started to thrive. But just 13 years later, I died of a stroke on June 3rd, 1953 at the age of 66. In my life, I composed over 300 pieces of music, including symphonies, concertos, choral works, chamber music, and instrumental solos. In fact, a large collection of my works were discovered at my abandoned summer home in 2009. How wonderful! As you can see, my journey to success wasn't always easy. I had a lot of obstacles to overcome, but I did it. I'm now recognized as one of the most notable composers in the 20th century, and my music is loved by many. Well, darling, thanks for letting me share a little bit with you today. I would love for you to listen to some of my music. I know you'll just love it. But for now, I will say goodbye and happy music making.